the mouse deer and the snail. On a sunny day, there is an animal that is known for being cunning in the forest. That is a mouse deer. That day, mouse deer was relaxing under a big tree with a gentle breeze that made mouse deer sleepy. He began to walk through the forest to get rid of his drowsiness. At the top of a hill, the mouse deer shouted arrogantly, "Oh, forest people, I'm the most cunning, clever, and resourceful animal in this forest. I can solve any problem easily," said the mouse deer. Mouse deer puffed out his chest and came down from the top of the hill. After walking quite a distance, he finally arrived at the riverside. The mouse deer immediately drank to quench his thirst while continuing to praise himself. Around there, he met a small snail. "Hello, mouse deer. You look like you are having a good time this morning. What's going on?" greeted the snail cheerfully. The mouse deer heard the snail voice and looked for the origin of the sound. He answered, "No, I just want to let everyone in the forest know that I'm the most cunning, clever, and the resourceful animal," replied the mouse deer arrogantly. The snail replied casually, "How arrogant you are, mouse deer. There must be other animals that can match your cleverness and ingenuity." "Who is it? You? Just look at your slow path, snail. Don't fantasize," said the mouse deer, belittling the snail with his weakness. The snail was surprised by the mouse deer's answer and made him angry. Then the snail replied to the mouse deer's words, "Hey mouse deer, I know you are known for being a cunning and fast animal, while I am known for a very slow walking animal. But this time, I was very angry to hear what you said earlier, and I challenge you to a race," said the snail. Hearing the challenge from the snail, mouse deer accepted the challenge because he knew the snail would not be able to beat him, until they finally agreed that the challenge was held the next day. After the mouse deer left, the snail realized that he could not beat the mouse deer. The snail quickly gathered his friends. He asked for help to an entire group of other snails to line up and hide along the track of the running race. The next day, the mouse deer and the snail were already at the place they agreed to race. "How about it, snail? Are you ready to race with me and lose?" asked the mouse deer arrogantly. "Of course I have, and I will definitely win," replied the snail. Then the snail led the mouse deer to run first and told the mouse deer to call him to make sure where the snail had reached. The mouse deer walked leisurely. After a while later, the mouse deer, who was curious to where the snail ran, finally asked aloud, "Snail, where are you?" The snail answered with a loud shout, "I'm in front of you." A Of course, the mouse deer was surprised and puzzled. How could a snail get ahead of him? Therefore, the mouse deer quickened his footsteps and then asked again, "Where are you, snail?" Again, the snail answered, "I'm in front of you." The mouse deer ran with all his might. He was exhausted. His legs felt weak, and his breath hitched. But strangely, every time the mouse deer asked where the snail was, he was always in front of the mouse deer. How surprised! The mouse deer almost arrived at the finish line. It turned out that the snail had arrived at the finish line first. Said cheerfully, "Hey, mouse deer, why are you taking so long? I've been here long ago." With feeling of sadness and shame, the mouse deer admitted defeat. "So, mouse deer, don't be arrogant. You are smart, but not smartest," said the snail. With feeling of regret, the mouse deer replied, "Yes, I am sorry, snail. I will not be arrogant anymore." So, the theme or core of the story of the mouse deer and the snail is about arrogance. Starting with the mouse deer arrogant, there was a sense of disapproval of the snail who felt humiliated by the mouse deer. The mouse deer is described as a clever but arrogant animal. Meanwhile, the snail is a smart but easily offended character. From the story of the mouse deer and the snail, you can take the mandate or message not to be arrogant and not to feel the greatest. Because every creature that lives in the world has its own advantage and disadvantage. Be grateful for whatever you have and never put other people down. Life is like a spinning wheel. Sometimes it's up, sometimes it's down. So, it is better for you to be humble and share goodness with others.